When I met them, Sophie and Margot in Amsterdam came here.
Away from your daily week life, whatever that may entail. I always like to check in to see who's never been here before, just in case they're newcomers. Hello. Well, thanks for coming out here. Hey, you made it up our stairs. That's like a major feat.
Yes. Thank you very much for the help.
Oh, you're welcome. And welcome everyone who's been here before. I see a lot of familiar faces. For those who are unfamiliar with it, we've been doing this for about 10 to 15 years, approximately 500 or so shows. So we hope you come back. We do music of all genre, and we are live streaming the shows. And I'm going to welcome those folks right now. Hello, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for being patient while I start the live stream late. Hopefully the audio's on. Anyway, so how many people are already familiar with Kathryn Clair and Margot Merah? So apparently you've been following them from their last gig, right? Or is this, where was your last gig?
Seattle.
So you all drove down here from Seattle? And I see your bus is parked outside. Well, it's fabulous. I'm so glad you came out tonight. I'm really thrilled to have them back because it's been some time since I've heard them perform together. And they've also brought some special guests for the second half. And so it's going to be a really special night. So thank you so much for joining us. And without further ado, I'm going to welcome Margot Merah, Kathryn Clair. Welcome.
Thanks for coming. Wow.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, we're gonna play you a lot of songs, and we're gonna play you, I think, every song of our new album. Yay!
Which is superb.
has been talking to the clouds. She said they'd hold off for a while. Wanted to believe her, so they stayed. And as the wind was picking up and darkness fell across the land, the long arms of the trees began to sway. Come close, come in, it's warm and dry here. Come close, come in, keep playing on. Come close, come in, the sky may open, around us rain will fall. Come close. Start of a new life, and times we gather to commit or say goodbye. I do not want to leave alone. I need your arms to bring me home. Faces of loved ones by my side. Come close, come in. It's warm and dry here. Come close.
That's Come Close, Come In, which is also the title of our CD. And we always love to open with that song because it's really a song about bringing communities together, like we do here tonight, or like Abby does here tonight. So yeah, it's a song about how we need each other. And we realize that, especially just coming out of the pandemic, like, oh yeah, it's just so important that we are all together. And we, you know, I know we had to have distance for a while, but really we need to come closer to people.
Mm-hmm. And that was a song, Margot and I wrote that song together, which was really cool. We wrote two songs on the album as a co-write, which we hadn't done before. And that came, we had played a really cool show kind of like this. An outdoor show where this big storm came in, and that was sort of the impetus for that song. But then we realized like there was also this whole feeling of just bringing people back together coming out of that time. So nice job writing that song. That was awesome.
Yeah. 2, 3, 4. foreign stranger traveling through this world of woe. There is no sickness, toil, or danger in this bright land to which I go. I'm going there to meet my father. I'm going there no more to roam. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over home. I know dark clouds will gather around me. I know my path is rough and steep. Golden fields lie just before me, where souls redeemed their vigils keep. I'm going there to meet my mother. She said she'd meet me when I come. Played a live stream last.
Oh yes. Hi everyone.
It's at 4:30 a.m. in the Netherlands. So, goedemorgen. If everybody's awake, I don't know. Probably not.
Mijn zuster heb ik speciaal ingelicht. Die kijkt ook.
Oh, en hoe heet ze?
In Zeist.
Hoe heet ze?
Els.
Hi Els. Yeah, oh, we have a secret language going on here.
Not too secret.
Oh, yeah. All right. We're going to sing you a song that I taught Kathryn driving to Eastern Oregon.
We were driving through, I think, Hell's Canyon.
Was
actually,
that the weather changing? Like sunny, hail, windy, sunny, within 5 hours?
Yeah,
something like that.
That too.
So 5 hours in the car, enough time to teach Kathryn this old song.
It was last Monday morning, the day appointed was for me to go down to the brew and meet my own true love. My heart so brisk and bonny to pay him company, and it's low, low down
I looked over my left shoulder to see what I could see. And there I saw my own true love come skipping down to me. His heart so brisk and bonny to pay me company. And it's low, low down in the broom, waiting in the broom for me. I quickly took his hand and gaily sang my heart. And now that we're together, I know we ne'er shall part. No part, my love, no, never. Such a thing can never. For it's low, low down in the broom, waiting in the broom for me. And it's low, low down in
last spring, and Margot and I did a few shows in Germany, and we were driving back, and we had this really, just like we do, we have a lot of great ideas on the road, and we were like, what if we make an album this spring, we release it in the summer, we just tour with it, and we were like, that's kind of crazy, isn't it? Because I'm going to be going home in like 3 days. So, anyway.
We were like, well, we have 3 months. I'm sure we can get it together.
Oh, we can totally do that.
Yeah.
So we did. And it was really, yes, it was a really cool experience. And our good friend Casey Neal mixed the album for us, which was such a gift. Yes. Casey is here tonight, so if you see him, tell him how awesome the album is. Yeah. Yeah, it was really cool. Just to be able to work with Casey, and Margot recorded all of her parts in Amsterdam. I recorded mine here, and he helped us really bring it together. But some of these songs we had put together in the recording and sort of played them for the first time last summer. I mean, really played them together, which was fun. And I think every time we're back together, since it's rare, I'm always just like, oh my gosh, it's so fun to sing with you. It's awesome. Okay, so anyway, this is our hit single from the record. We didn't write this one.
We did not write
this one. Okay.
Someday, you dream maker, huckleberry friend.
Called a melodica.
Yes.
For those of you who did not know that. And so we released the album on Spotify only last week, but this song has been on there since last summer when we went on tour again and the city was just ready. We were like, well, it's such a summery song, why don't we release that? It's all about escaping the hot city in the summer and going to find some quiet place wherever you can get your head quiet as well. Did I say that right?
That was beautiful. Yeah. And we wrote this together.
We did.
This is our second co-write. Yes.
In my head, can't turn it down. We need to get away. Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling. Floating on a river of quiet. Floating on a river of quiet. The height of the summer, the heat is on. Are hanging low. Pack up the car, get out of town, time to let it go. Oh, my darling. Oh, my darling. Floating on a river quiet. Floating on a river quiet. let's go to the river quiet. Floating on a river of quiet. Mm-hmm. Watch the water ripple through a silver trout below. A couple in an old canoe, silent hello.
Introduce you to the ooh-ooh-ooh-ah-hoo bit. you were spot on.
Yeah. That was really great.
Tell them what river you were riffing on.
Oh, we've been dipping in lots of rivers on our way to Montana last year. Kathryn had made this whole tour all the way to Montana because I'd never been there. And we tried to dip in every river that we crossed, but I don't think we made it all that far. But
We got into a lot of rivers, and they were very cold.
River.
Okay, so.
Tunes?
Yes. Mm-hmm. This is a set of tunes that I wrote for the album, and the first tune is called Time Long Past, and I picked up the melody that I played in that first song, Come Close, Come In, and kind of built it into more of a tune. And then there's two jigs at the end. The first jig is called Pine Canyon, and the second tune is called The Road Ahead.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to read that song? Do you want to read it?
Yeah, I'll be there. Is that good?
Okay. Yeah, this is also off the album. I wrote this, during the recording process, so Kathryn did not know the song before she recorded it. And then last summer we got to play it for the first time, actually together. It's a song called Be Kind, and it's written from the perspective of somebody who is dying and who's looking back on his or her life saying, it's okay, I had a good life, I had a beautiful life, even I had a long life, so we all need to go sometime. So if this is my time, I'm happy with that.
For those of you that don't, Margot and I met in Amsterdam in a little Irish pub 11 years ago, and I was opening. Margot plays in this amazing duo in the Netherlands called the Lasses, and
hi. You never know who's watching.
You never know who's watching.
Sweet. Yeah, we met in a bar on the river Amstel.
Yep. And I was going to open for the lasses at this little pub called Mulligan's in Amsterdam, but we met the night before at this session and just instantly hit it off and played that gig together. And at the end of that gig, I missed the last train, or I decided to miss the last train, because Margot said she would give me a ride home to where I was staying across the city, and she gave me a ride on the back of her bicycle with her guitar, my fiddle, a barrel, and I was just like sitting on the back. It was spectacular. And she's like, you know, going up and over the canals like this. I was like, this woman is so awesome. I want to know this lady for a long time. So here we are. Yeah. All right, so a little nod to Mulligan's and our roots in Irish music.
Mulligan's is no more.
In the lowlands of Craigan, there lives a white hare. Swift as a swallow, she flies through the air. You may travel the country, but none can compare with the pride of the Craigan, the bunny white hare. One bright Sunday morning, as you may suppose, a red golden sun or the green mountain rose, Bonnie Conway came down and did loudly declare, today I'll put an end to the Craigan white hare. So he searched through the lowlands and down through the glen, among the green rushes where the white hare had danced, till at last coming over the bog bank so bare, from behind the wild thistle out jumped the white hare.
excited to do this next number and to call up our very first special secret, super secret surprise special guest this evening, Sid Ditson on the fiddles and vocals. Oh, this is quite a treat because Margot and I have played so often and over the years for so long, but Sid and I have also played together and for so many years. So it's kind of like a duo becomes a trio for this one.
Where do you want to be?
I can be here. Oh, do you want, or should I be in the middle?
Yeah.
Does it feel weird? Okay. Okay. All right.
No, I mean, I want to be here, but just not in the middle.
So this is a song I wrote and Margot and I recorded on the album, and it's called Traveling Dreams, and I wrote this during the pandemic, and it really shares the idea was not to lose sight of your traveling dreams, which was encouraged by something that Rick Steves said. And I wrote this song based on that. He had described his favorite travel memory in this interview, and it was so beautiful about being in Tuscany. And afterwards I was like, oh, I'm just gonna think about all of my favorite travel memories. And one of them was singing with Margot in Amsterdam, and one of them was traveling in Japan with on the Shinkansen with my friends, and all kinds of other ones. So I put them in this song, and now we're here.
Voice of the man on the end of the line says, I'll tell you of a table filled with fresh bread and red wine, cured meats and cheeses, rich soil and sea breezes, and a family gathered around. Close your eyes and imagine the sound. Laughter and stories in an unfamiliar tongue. I can't speak many words, but it doesn't stop anyone from sharing these moments under a tree on a small farm outside Tuscany. If I had one wish, that's where I'd like. Back to those places traveling and don't give up your traveling dream.
Oh.
Woo. Yeah. All right, well, our final super secret special guest of the evening is our dear friend Alan Hunter on the upright bass. We have many different friends and combinations of people in this room tonight who have traveled in some of the places that we've been talking about and singing about. And Alan and Sid and I toured in Europe, stayed at Margot's house many a night, and have shared stages with her over there. But this is, we played last summer. We played one show last summer at the Laurel Thirst, which was super fun. But this is like the reunion show. Reunion show, I guess. Oh, this man. Anyway, Margot and I... No Keiko, right?
No Keiko. Yeah. I was just thinking, okay.
Margot and I, we went all the way out to Montana last summer, and we played the weirdest gig up in Glacier National, right at the edge of Glacier, in a little place called Pole Bridge. And they have this amazing venue in the middle of nowhere with a gorgeous little stage and this guy that runs sound and runs the place. It was so wonderful, and we love them. Hi, Dan and Fran, if you're watching. And they, we had the session afterwards, and this lovely guy was singing this song, and we were like, God, that's a great song. So we learned it on our drive back to Idaho, and taught it to these guys, I think, right before that gig last year. But we're reprising it. This is a Merle Haggard song called Big City. Ready?
Yeah.
A womp, a two, a womp.
Not enough faith.
It's a warning. Well, thank you so much. I see that people are waving our CD. We hadn't even mentioned that we have them here.
I know. We got upstairs and we were like, oh, we forgot to say anything about the CDs. Do you want to say a little something about...
Yes.
Okay, yeah.
The teacups. And
so we have made the CD, like we mentioned. Mm-hmm. And Kathryn made the artwork for this. And it's so beautiful.
Thank you.
Yes, and there's a whole story to, you know, you see some Oregon, you see some river, you see a little house where people can gather and shelter from the rain and all that. And of course you can buy this one, would be highly appreciated. But there's a lot of people who do not have a CD player anymore.
Right.
And we have something special for you too.
What is that, Margot? Well, what do we have?
So glad you asked.
Thank you,
Dad. I'm so glad you asked. Because of the whole gathering, come close, come in theme that's all over this album, we thought, isn't it nice if we have a download code for you so that you can listen to the album? And we have put that.
But what if I wanted to drink a cup of tea while I listen to the album?
I just have the thing for you. We have been to thrift shops and we have selected a beautiful bouquet of mugs and cups. And in them, we have put two bags of peppermint tea, which is Kathryn's favorite tea, and two bags of ginger lemon, which is my favorite tea. So you can go home, you can make yourself a nice cup of tea in this cup, and you can listen to our album. Aww. And feel all included.
Oh, that's perfect, Margo. I love it.
I am not made for commercial breaks.
No, you are.
But it's fine.
That was really good.
And of course, it's also Kathryn's albums, both on CD and on vinyl. And there's
Margot's album.
There's my
beautiful
album, and there's things to look at.
Yes.
And buy.
And buy.
Yes, and also you can buy them.
Yes.
Thank you.
And then after you bought this, it would be really great if you would all go home with a CD, and then put our music on Spotify or Apple Music and just play it all night long. You can just put it on mute, but we get 0.3 cents for every time you play a song.
Right.
Anyway, is everybody back?
And welcome back to the live stream. This is the last song that we haven't played from the album, so we'll play it for you now. This is a Dolly Parton song.
Oh, yes.
Little sparrow, little sparrow, precious, fragile little thing. Little sparrow, little sparrow, fly so high. Feels no pain. All you maidens, heed my warning. Do not trust the hearts of men. They will crush you like a sparrow, leaving you to never. They will vow to always love you, swear no love but yours will do. Then they'll go and court another, break you.
would flutter all about him on my little sparrow wings. I would ask him why he let me love him then. I am not little sparrow, I am
this song came about after I visited a songwriter circle. Every 2 weeks, a couple of songwriters would meet and we would share our latest work. Even sometimes that was even just one line, sometimes that was half a song, sometimes it was almost finished. And the idea was that it was a safe environment to try out things. You know, we can be very judgmental about our own work. And one of the things that happened there as well is that we got little assignments to do. Like, okay, write a song about this, or, you know, try to do this or that. And I had missed 1 week, and that's why I could choose out of 2 assignments. And the one assignment was write a song about a color. And for 2 weeks, I had been thinking about the color green. And I had written notes on, you know, everything that was green, or that could be green, the feeling of green, the smell of green, the touch of green, and I had gotten absolutely nowhere. like 2 pages in my book and not even anything to start up with.
Oh.
So the other assignment that I thought was like, I'll leave that be, but the other assignment was to write a song out of your comfort zone. And about 2 hours before I needed to go back to this meeting, all of a sudden I thought, jazz. Let's try and write a jazz song. And I wrote this song, I wrote half of this song, and then I went to this evening and I played it and everybody was like, yeah, okay, you could take it this direction, you could take it that direction. We're very curious what it's gonna end up with in 2 weeks. And I was like, oh, darn, now I need to finish it. So I finished it and I apologize to all serious jazz musicians because it's probably not jazz, but folk music usually has 3 or 4 chords and this has a lot more. It's called jazz. Nomi. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you didn't like my style. Why don't you tell me? You don't like the way I dress. Why would you wait? Would you wait to watch me fall? You don't know me. You don't know me at all. You don't know my dream.
This is funny. I started this song when we had that eclipse in 2018. 17? Thank you. 2017. Wow, that's a long time ago. So, I know there was just the big eclipse on Monday, and anyway, it's called Leave Behind. I love playing it with Sid, and I love playing it with Margot, but this is the first time getting to play with them together, so. Summer flew past faster than I had remembered it passing.
last year. Of course we were nearer to the source of it all, spinning round on this blue and green ball. Oceans and lands, tinier still than these grains of sand in my hand, blowing away. You blow me away, but we weren't intended to stay.
Is a little bit responsible for this next song. So Kathryn and I had been touring in the Netherlands together with Sophie, together with the lasses. And Alan was in the Netherlands. Maybe you had been touring with Kathryn as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's
terribly awesome.
We played in Sophie's hometown from Spierdijk. And it's a tiny town north of Amsterdam. And we drove back, it was October, we drove back over the flatlands of the Netherlands.
You didn't bicycle?
No.
Not for this one.
No. No, we do a lot of bicycling, but this was a little too far. I have a tiny car. I have a little Mitsubishi. And we were in there with the Kathryn, me, and Sophie. And then Sophie's sister was there as well. And Alan Hunter was there.
And all of our instruments.
And we had two guitars, a bodhran, a violin. It was all fine.
It was cozy.
It was cozy.
I just remember Alan in the back with, like, your knees up to you. Just kind of like...
We were driving over the flatlands of the Netherlands, and on the left of me, I was the one with the most space because I was driving. It's very comfortable. On the left of me, there was this big moon rising, and Alan Hunter says, "Do you know that's called the Hunter Moon?" And I instantly made a mental note: Hunter Moon, Hunter Moon. And I had been writing a song for a while already, and it lacked something. And that came with the knowledge of that full moon of October is called the Hunter Moon.
There you go.
So this song is called the Hunter Moon, and it's I always love playing it, and it's always very special. And the funny thing is there are so many different versions, because I've played it with Sophie, and then with Kathryn, and I recorded it with somebody else, so there's many different versions, and I'm just super excited for this version with Alan Hunter.
Well, and I recorded it.
Yeah.
Oh yes.
Yeah, I played the bass on your record.
Yes, because I recorded it in my solo album, and I was like, there's only one person who can play the bass for that song. So there was another, like, I'll just send you the files, and you just play, and you send them back to me, and we'll make it happen.
Yeah.
So, thank you.
Thank you.
For naming the song, and making sure it's happening.
Try to provide a service. All
right. Do it so well. Inside your heart, living there. Trees stand tall beside the road, you pass them fast. As they grow slow, I know the pain you're running from, I know. The hunter moon, it rises on the let the moonlight guide you. Shine a light and shows you where you stand. Like it did to those before you. Let the moonlight guide you. trust in me, I'm at your side, you know.
Just trust in me, I'm at your side, you know. The hunter moon, it rises on the land. Let the moonlight guide you. Shine a light and shows you where you stand. Like it did to those before you.
Super long. I totally forgot to tell you that the tune at the end of this song was written by Kathryn Clare. She wrote it on a run in Amsterdam.
It's true. It's true. All right. Well, I'm gonna play one of my older songs that I love to play with Alan and Sid, and then I love to sing with Margot. So here we go.
Un, deux, trois.
Please don't give me anything. It will only end up in a box. Broken necklaces and beads of ivory and mismatched socks. I cannot keep up with it. I surely shouldn't try. That is why I don't want anything except perhaps that twinkle in your eye. On the floor, I spill the contents of this treasure chest. I count the coins and tie the knots, and I throw away the rest.
If it doesn't fit me, then it must be out of style. All the while, I don't want anything. I wouldn't mind a glimpse of your. A song in your mind.
Sedans in the moonlight.
Yeah.
Even if there's no moon. No, it's actually, it was nice weather today, so maybe it's a clear sky, but we were in Seattle and on Whidbey Island it was gray. But if you walk out and there is no moon to be seen, you can be a little creative and look at a like a lantern and just squint a bit. I think that'll do.
That'll do.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I know it's late, I know you're tired, we should be sleeping. For today is yesterday, and morning's near. But you may take your arms while Bowley singing. About the thought of you, the very thought of you, my dear. And we'll dance, dance. Sight It's not too right, just as I wonder if it's more than just another day that starts. Then maybe in the deepest night, by quick, quick, slow, good old Cupid shot his arrow through my heart.
Song called The Cuckoo.
Oh, yeah.
My favorite song. We do, oh, the cuckoo, oh, the cuckoo. She's a pretty bird.
She's a pretty bird.
And she warbles and she flies. Yeah, everybody knows this, I think. But she never,
but she never
says cuckoo.
Says cuckoo.
Till the fourth day of July. Oh, my goodness, yeah. Harmonies already, and everything's great.
Since
gonna build me a log cabin on a mountain so high, so that I can see my darling as she goes passing by. One more song to sing for you tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So this is going to be our last song. Unless really loud and shout things like more and
encore.
And that kind of stuff. And if you clap really loud, maybe Alan Hunter and Sid will say, like, okay, we'll do one.
Yeah, maybe. We'll see.
But so, thank you, Abby. I don't know where Abby is. Abby is hard at work, probably. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. There you go.
I am blown over with your music. Seriously, I can't believe what I just heard tonight. So,
thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
I feel like I'm hearing a whole nother like concert in the kitchen, and it's a whole other thing. But you're really hearing like the 100% 360. 5D, whatever. thank you so much for coming, and it's been fabulous tonight. So
thank you for being here.
Thank you for tuning in online. It's been great to enjoy the concert with you in the kitchen.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody.
And of course, also a huge thank you for coming here tonight.
Mm-hmm. Thank you
our
so
hearts
much.
That you would be here with us.
All right, we're going to do this song. This is also a sing-along for you. And it's a song I wrote called The Ways of the World. And you're going to sing, the chorus is going to go like this. Oh, the ways of the world. Try that. thank you, everybody. This is too fun. If you know any people in Port Townsend, Margot and I will be there, and Timothy Hall will be sharing the night with us. It's going to be a beautiful show on Friday night. So if you have any friends in that area, let them know.
Or if you have a car.
And you want to get away for the weekend.
We came all the way from Seattle, so.
Yeah, exactly. It's just kind of like, exactly.
Oh, yes. Sorry, I almost believed you there. Very naive.
All right, well, we'll end with this one.
Thanks again.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Every song.